The retrofit apron front farm sink with dual mount capability is for experienced and professional installation only. This installation project is designed for an advanced skill level. Undermount application must use a modified sink base and solid surface countertop material. The following requirements are very important. Countertop must be flat. This sink will not install to countertops with integral drip edges. Countertop thickness cannot exceed 1.5 inches or 38 millimeters. Countertop cannot overhang the cabinet face more than 1.5 inches or 38 millimeters. Countertop must be fully supported by the cabinet. Also very important, proper installation requires a coordinated effort, including advanced dialogue between designer or customer, the cabinet maker, the countertop fabricator, and sink installer during the design and installation phase. Before installing the sink, inspect it for damage. Do not install a damaged unit. Take caution against risk of personal injury. Metal surfaces are sharp and can cause severe cuts. Please use gloves and handle sink with care. Instructions are specific to new countertop installation or replacement. Be sure to follow the instructions that apply to your installation. Also, inspect the drain and supply lines and replace if necessary. Remember, it is your responsibility to follow all local plumbing and building codes. Warranty will be voided if these installation instructions are not followed. Tools required for installation include tape measure, wood glue, safety glasses, painter's tape, felt tip marker, laminate jigsaw blade, scissors, saw, sandpaper, silicone sealant, utility knife, level, flat screwdriver, square, hand wood saw, and foam brush. Please view this important checklist before you start. This checklist is designed to assist you in making an informed decision on the selection of your retrofit apron front farm sink. The following 5 items will assist you in determining if your current kitchen cabinet can use this type of sink. First, countertop must be flat to assure proper sink installation. Therefore, countertops with a no-drip edge will not work with this sink installation. Second, your sink base cabinet must be 36 inches wide. Third, your cabinet should have false drawer fronts. Some cabinets have one large false drawer front, and some have 2 false drawer fronts. Fourth item on the checklist, the dimension between the cabinet styles must be 33 inches. This measurement is the open space from left to right when the false drawer front is removed. Finally, on the checklist, measure the distance from top of the door rail to top of the cabinet. This will determine the apron height of the sink you can choose. To account for the typical countertop height, add 1.5 inch to the measurement. This total will tell you which sink to choose. Please note, typical cabinet height from the rail to the top of the cabinet is 6 inches or 6.5 inches. If 6 inches plus typical countertop height of 1.5 inch, a total 7.5 inches apron height is required. If 6.5 inches plus typical countertop height of 1.5 inch, a total 8 inches of apron height is required. 7.5 inches is a flat apron front, while 8 inches is a curved apron front. Take note that a 7.5 inch flat front sink can be used for an 8 inch height. But for this application, a trim strip must be placed under the sink to cover the 1.5 inch opening. Trim strip is not included. If your cabinet and countertop meet the criteria of this checklist, choose from the list of apron front farm sinks shown here. Prepare the cabinet for new countertop installation. Remove the false fronts, typically 2 small or 1 large panel, and be careful not to damage the cabinet front. Apply painter's tape to the cabinet front. This will help prevent damaging the surface when cutting out the drawer fronts. If your cabinet has 2 smaller false fronts, it will have a center support. If the cabinet does have a center support, remove it at this time by cutting along the bottom, even with the drawer opening, while making sure you do not cut into the cabinet. Remove the top rail and be careful not to cut into the cabinet styles. New countertop installation. It is very important to make sure your countertop is compatible with this retrofit apron front farm sink. countertop thickness cannot exceed 1.5 inches or 38 millimeters, and countertop cannot overhang the cabinet face more than 1.5 inches or 38 millimeters. Countertop must be fully supported by the cabinet. If not fully supported, shim the countertop as needed and make sure the countertop is fully supported along the entire depth of the cabinet. Install the countertop per manufacturer's instructions. Preparing your countertop. Put painter's tape at the center line of the cabinet from the front of the backsplash to the front edge of the countertop. Put painter's tape across the front edge of the countertop along the entire width of the sink base cabinet. Mark the center line of the cabinet onto the painter's tape. Trace the template. Cut out the paper template along the top mount marked line. Cut out the diamond on the template. This will help you line up the center line, and it should be in the center of the diamond. Apply painter's tape to all exposed outside edges prior to securing the template in place, as this will prevent chipping when cutting. Put the template on the countertop and line the template up with the lines marked on the painter's tape over the pre-existing hole. Put the two notches from the template 1 15/16 inch from the edge of the countertop. Tape the template in place. Trace the template onto the applied painter's tape. Trace the notches at the front of the template. Remove the template. Put painter's tape to the front of the countertop to prevent chipping the laminate when cutting. Extend the mark lines down the front of the countertop onto the painter's tape. Cut the countertop. It is very important to cut the countertop in this step-by-step order to avoid cutting the cabinet surfaces. A couple tips to remember. Apply painter's tape to the edge of the countertop when cutting to prevent chipping the laminate. Also, this tip, make sure your equipment is in good working order. Sharp blades ensure a smooth installation and straight cuts. Using the laminate saw blade, cut the countertop along the inside marked line. Carefully cut away from the cutout to the marked notch line. Do be careful not to damage the cabinet face. Repeat this step on the other side. Another tip, use sandpaper to smooth all cut edges. Lower the sink carefully into the countertop opening to make sure it fits, but don't force it. The fit will be tight, but if the opening is too small, recheck your dimensions. It is also important to spread a generous amount of wood glue on both notches to seal the newly exposed wood. This helps make the area water resistant to prevent water from penetrating into the wood and swelling the underlayment. Be sure to wipe away any excess glue and allow wood glue to dry completely. Install the sink. To protect the cabinet finish, temporarily put painter's tape around the cabinet cutout. Apply a bead of silicone around the cutout. Carefully lower the sink into the cabinet. Be sure to wipe away any excess silicone sealant. Install the clips from under the cabinet. Slide 3 clips into either side of the back rail of the sink. Slide 2 clips into each side rail of the sink. Evenly space the clips. Assemble the screws into the U-channel fasteners as shown. Do note, screws are designed to insert into the channel fasteners with backward threading so that when mounting, screws will turn in a counterclockwise direction. Locate the fasteners in the position as shown. Hand tighten each fastener onto the channel so that the clamp teeth point is in the same direction as the U-channel. To install U-channel fasteners in channel bar, slide U-channel fasteners in channel bar either from open end or slots in the channel. Position the fastener's claw under the top edge and locate the fastener in position as shown. Use caution when tightening. Improper tightening of channel fasteners could result in improper installation or cause damage to the sink. Place U-channel fasteners equally spaced and with one at each end of channel bar. Hand tighten channel fasteners beginning at the center and working toward the sides. Then recheck the sink position on the countertop. Tighten all channel fasteners an additional 1/4 of a turn with a flathead screwdriver. It is very important that fasteners are not over-tightened. Finishing the installation. Apply silicone sealant around the edge of the sink. Be sure to completely cover the notched area where the countertop meets the apron front sink. Wipe away excess sealant before it dries. Install the faucet and drain per the manufacturer's installation instructions. To add a finishing touch to your new sink, a furring strip can be added around the apron, but be sure the cabinet doors have clearance to accept a furring strip. For under-counter mount installation, see other instructions. Please refer to printed installation instructions for complete limited lifetime warranty information and legal disclaimer. Printed instructions are available on the website menards.com.